Hello, good morning to everyone. I am Gaurav Gupta, Azure Mathematics teacher. Today we will discuss the graph theory of the remaining polynomials, quadratic polynomials as well as cubic polynomial. In our second lecture, what we were discussed, we discussed the graph theory, how we represent a linear polynomial in a Cartesian plane and how many of zeros in linear polynomial. So we note the zeros we can be determined by looking the graph. How many points the graph cut the x-axis is called the number of zeros. Again I repeat, you have to calculate the number of zeros, and how you can find out the number of zeros, you have to look the graph and find out how many points the graph cut the x-axis. That number of times is called the number of zeros of the polynomial. In the previous lecture, what we were discussed, we were seen that only one point, the lines cut the x-axis at one point. So we can say that its geometrical meaning, the number of zeros of a linear polynomial is only one. Now we will take an example of quadratic polynomial. So as we know how we represent a quadratic polynomial, this is a standard form of to represent a quadratic polynomial, ax square plus bx plus c. So I draw in Cartesian planes and I give an example of a quadratic equation. Firstly, we have to calculate the number of zeros, as usually we have finds by using method of middle term splitting. Then we have to verify according to its graph. Firstly, we do according to our algebra, then we apply the graph theory. So we can verify by both of these methods. So firstly, we have to do find out its number of zero by using method of middle term splitting. So in this, we can find out the number of zeros as the middle term is minus 3. So we have to divide it in two parts, minus 3 divided into two parts, so that if we add them, we get minus 3, and if we multiply them, we get minus 4. So the term will be positive, negative 4 plus 1, negative 4 plus 1, because if we add them, we get minus 3, and if we multiply minus 4 by 1, we get minus 4. So we are divides the middle term, minus 3 in two parts, minus 4 plus 1, because if we add them, minus 4 plus 1, which is equal to minus 3. Now apply this method to find out the number of zeros. We split, minus 3 is written as minus 4 plus 1, and also minus 3 associated with x, so we associate x to each term also, as well as 4, as well as with 1. So we can write minus 3x is equal to minus 4x plus x. What we will got? Minus 3x minus 4. Now what's the common in between first two term? In this we have take common x. If we take common x, then what's the result will be remains x minus 4. Now if we take one common, then what we will got here? X minus 4. Again I repeat, in this we have take common x, so we get x minus 4. Now in this term we get 1, we got a result of x minus 4. Now x minus 4 are coming common out from both the terms, so we take common x minus 4. What we will got? X positive 1, so x plus 1. Now put equal to 0, because we have to find out the 0, and 0 are the values of x on which the polynomial becomes 0. That's why we have to put 1y equal to 0. So either this term will be 0 or this term will be 0. So if we put them, we get x is equal to 4, and for this we get an equality of x is equal to minus 1. It means this polynomial has only 2 0, which indicates that if we plot such a graph in a Cartesian plane, then it will cut the x-axis at only two points, not the other points. Is it possible or not? We have to verify it by using the graph theory. So to plot a graph, I have to plot first to make a table for different values of x, and we have to calculate corresponding value of the polynomial. So now we have to take or make a table. So here I am going to make a table. Here I am taking the values of x, and here I am taking the values of the polynomial. As we have, polynomial is p of x is equal to x square minus 3x minus 4. x square minus 3x minus 4. You can start from 0, or you can start from even minus 1, minus 2, and so on. You have to take 3 or more values for by which you can plot or you can estimate what's the graph of this quadratic polynomial. That's why I am choosing more than 3 values, so you can verify the what's the graph, which type of shape, either it's circle, sphere, or any curve, or straight line. We have to verify it by plotting the number of points in the Cartesian plane. So suppose I am taking example of start from minus 2. If I substitute here p of minus 2, what I will got? Minus 2 square minus 3 into minus 2 minus 4, which is equal to 4 minus 3 into minus 2 plus 6 minus 4. 6 plus 4, 10 minus 4 is equal to 6. It means if I put minus 2, we get a value of 6. Now if I enter, I am taking the values of x is equal to minus 1. Then what will be the values of the polynomial? We have to check. Minus 1, if I put minus 1 square minus 3 into minus 1 minus 4. Minus 1 square is positive 1, minus minus plus 3 minus 4. 3 plus 1, 4 minus 4, which is equal to 0. It means minus 1, we get the values of 0. And here you can also verify that. Here x is equal to minus 1, which is your 0. And by putting the values of x is equal to minus 1, we get the 0. It means we verify our first 0 is x is equal to minus 1. And you have to calculate its another 0. Now I am taking the values of 0. So if I put p of 0, then what will be the values? X is 0 minus 3 into 0 minus 4. It means minus 4. We get a value of minus 4. In this manner, please make a table 4 and 5 and plot a graph. So please make a note first. So we make a table for different values of x and corresponding values of px. You can find out and we can verify. Now we have to plot them one by one. First, our value is x is equal to minus 2, and the values of polynomial is positive 6. It means the values of x is minus 2 and the values of the polynomial is 6. It means it comes here. If we plot them, our second value is minus 1 and the polynomial becomes 0. It means the values of x is equal to minus 1 and the values of the polynomial is 0. It means we get a point this. Now join this. Now put third point. Whenever x is equal to 0, the value of the polynomial is minus 4. X value is 0 and the values of the polynomial is minus 4. Join this. When x is equal to 1, y values, polynomial values is 6. Again, you have to verify that. Sorry, once again, please make a note first. So, plot them. The values of x is equal to 1 and the values of x is minus 6. So, So here x, the values of x is 1 and the values of the polynomial is minus 6. So we get the points here. Now join this. Now values of x is 2 and the polynomial values is minus 6. X is equal to 2, polynomial values is minus 6. Join this. Now whenever x is equal to 3, the values of the polynomial is minus 4. See, which we get minus 4. Then 4, 0. It means this value, if we similar manner, 5 and 6. This is 5 and we get here 6. If you plot then all those points, so we get a graph in such manners. So look at the graph. This graph will go upward but never cut in other where remaining parts of the x-axis. So it is clearly visible that this graph cut the x-axis at only two points. First point is this and second point is this. So this graph clearly visible that the quadratic polynomial has only two zeros. First one is this, second one is this. So we will discuss already the quadratic polynomial has two zeros, and if we use the graph theory and locate all this point and plot a graph of the quadratic polynomial, we get a graph of like this curve, and this curve cut the x-axis at only two points. And the number of points at which it cut the x-axis is called the number of zero. So that's why it is clearly visible from the geometrical meaning of the graph. It shows the number of zeros of the quadratic polynomial is 2. So please make a note first. So now I am going to take an example of a cubic polynomial, and we have to discuss its geometrical meaning. So in our first lecture, I take an example of cubic polynomial x cube plus 3x square minus x minus 3, and we discussed how we get the zeros of the cubic polynomials. So those students still not watch my first lecture, please watch my first lecture and create your base how we calculate the number of zeros of a cubic polynomial. You can't try understand, so comment me on my YouTube channel Gaurav Gupta Math Classes. I will explain it again. So according to our first lecture, we already find out the number of zeros of such a quadratic cubic polynomials. Not a quadratic, it's a cubic polynomial because the degree of x is 3. So we found that number of zeros are minus 1, minus 3 and 1 in our first lecture. Now we have to verify from its geometrical by using graph theory. So I have made different values of the variable and calculate the values of the polynomial at each value. Suppose first I take value x is equal to minus 3, and what will be the values of the polynomial? This is your polynomial p of x. If I am taking x is minus 3, it means I have to put x as minus 3. If I put here, we get minus 3 cube plus 3 into minus 3 square minus 3 minus 3. Minus 3 cube is minus 27, minus 3 square is 9, 9 into 3, 27 plus 3. Minus 3, which means 27, 27, 3, 3, we get a 0. It means the polynomial becomes 0. That's why this is a 0 of the given polynomial. And we already discussed minus 3 is a 0 of this cubic polynomial. Now we have to discuss next value. Now I'm going to take x is equal to minus 2. P of minus 2. Now substitute x as minus 2. What we will got? Minus 2 cube plus 3 into minus 2 square minus 2 minus 3. Minus 2 cube is minus 8, माइनस टू स्क्वेयर इज फोर, फोर इंटू थ्री ट्वेल्व, नेगेटिव नेगेटिव प्लस टू इज इक्वल टू माइनस वन, माइनस एट एंड माइनस थ्री विच इज इक्वल टू माइनस इलेवन, ट्वेल्व प्लस टू विच इज इक्वल टू फोर्टीन, वी गेट थ्री. इट मीन्स वेन एवर पुट i माइनस थ्री I get the values x, p of x is equal to 0. Whenever I put x is equal to minus 2, I get the values of 3. It means in this type, polynomial does not become 0. So that's why x is equal to minus 2 is not a 0 of the cubic polynomial. So in this manner, you have to take values of different values of x and calculate corresponding values of the polynomial. Please do calculate. So by putting different values of x, we get the different values of the polynomial. So please look at this table and find out on which values of x the polynomial becomes 0. Here the polynomial becomes 0 at which value? Minus 8. It means x is equal to minus 3 is your polynomial. It's a zeros of the cubic polynomial. Now check here again 0. It means x value has minus 1. So minus 1 is also a 0. Now look at this 0. Again the polynomial becomes 0. At which value? X is equal to 1. You check it. 1 is your also 0. So this method indicates that number of zeros are this. And we can also verify by putting different values of x and calculate the values of the polynomial. So if we plot them, then what type of graph we will obtain? Please make a graph. First value is x is equal to minus 3 and the polynomial value is 0. It means we get this point. Now we have to take x is equal to minus 2 and the values of the polynomial is 3. It means positive 3. We get this point. Now we have to take minus 1. The values of the polynomial is 0. When I take whenever x is equal to minus 1, the values of the polynomial is 0. It means minus 1, the polynomial values is 0. Now whenever x is 0, the values of the polynomial is minus 3. X is 0 and the values of the polynomial is minus 3. When x is 1, the values of the polynomial is 0. When x is 2, the values of the polynomial is 15. It means it got here. So by joining all these points and check what's the graph of a cubic polynomial. Such type, if we plot this. So look at this graph very carefully and calculate the number of points on which the polynomial becomes 0. Clearly visible. Firstly, this point. Because this line indicates that with which polynomial becomes 0. Your x-axis indicates the values of the polynomial on which it becomes 0. So your first point is this. It means your first 0. X is equal to minus 3. Second, this one is. It means the values of the second 0 is minus 1. Now this one is the third, that is x is equal to 1. So the graph looks like this and it cut the x-axis at 3 points, 1, 2 and 3. So the cubic polynomial has 3, 0. This is the geometrical representation or the graph theory of a cubic polynomial. I hope this will be clear to you. Please make a note first. So our next topic is same based on the graph theory and which is also your exercise 2.1. Whenever you study these graphs and you will easily find out the number of 0. Again I revise the definition of 0. We have to look at the graph and find out how many or how many number of times it cut the x-axis, and number of times is called the number of 0. So look at only the x-axis, not the y-axis. So your first question is, find out the number of zeros by looking at the graph and find out the number of zeros. So look at the first graph. You clearly see this graph cut the x-axis at two points. First point is your this A and B. It means it has number of zeros is equal to 2. That is your answer. Now look at this graph. How many points it cut the x-axis? Only this. It means only one point cut the x-axis. We have not checked at the y-axis. We have to check only the x-axis. Here, this is the x-axis. It cut at only one point. So number of zeros is 1. Your answer. Now look at this graph. How many points? This one is your first point. This one is your second point, and this one is your third. It means A, B, C. The number of zeros is equal to 3. So your answer is 3. Now look at this graph. It cut the x-axis at only one point. So number of zeros is 1. Now look at this graph. On which, how many points it cut the x-axis? This is your first point. This one is your second point. This one is your third point. This one is your fourth point. It means answer, the number of zeros is 4. Please make a note. So our next topic is relationship between zeros and the coefficient of a polynomial. We already discussed what's the zeros and coefficients means the term associated with x is called coefficient. So for example, if I am talking about coefficient of x, then what will be the coefficient of x is a. Whenever I am talking to what is constant term, the constant term is b, because the term which has no value of x associated, means whenever x is not associated with any value is called a constant. So this is the general expression for a linear polynomial. And we already know how we calculate the zeros, but we have to relate. Relate means we have to find out the relationship between the number of zeros and the coefficients. So in the case of linear polynomial, what's the relationship with the zero, which is equal to, as we know, number of zeros of a linear polynomial is 1. Number of zeros is 1. Only one zero associated with a linear polynomial. Let's suppose k, the values of x at which the polynomial becomes 0. What's the value of the 0 is minus b by a. This was already discussed in our lecture first. What is b? B is your constant term. Divide a. What is a coefficient of x? Coefficient of constant term divided by coefficient of x, you can calculate its 0. For example, I am taking an example. Polynomial p of x is equal to 2x plus 3. Now we have to calculate the 0. What's the method to calculate the 0 is without its coefficient terms. Firstly, we have to put it equal to 0. So 2x plus 3 is equal to, polynomial becomes equal to 0, and get the values of x. If we take 3 as a left hand side, we get minus 3 is equal to 2x. Now what's the values of x? If we take 2 on the left hand side, we get minus 3 divided by 2. So minus 3 divided by 2, it's a 0. And you have to verify Now we have to verify it. What's the method of verification? It's a coefficients of a polynomial. Right? Coefficient of a polynomial. Firstly, you have to find out the zeros as you usually do. This is your first method, how we can calculate the number of zeros. Now we have to verify it by using the coefficients method. So first one is your, this is your coefficient method for the case of linear polynomial. You have to know this. Its zero is zero. How we calculate the zeros is basically minus p by a. This is the easiest method to calculate the values of the zeros in terms of its coefficients. So b, firstly we have to take sign negative. We take negative. Now b indicates your constant term. And what's the constant term in this? 3, because in this x is not associated with. So 3 is your constant. So put it 3 divided by coefficient of x, and coefficient of x is here 2. So this is your left hand side and this one is your right hand side. So left hand side is equal to right hand side. It means you have verified that x is equal to minus 3 by 2 is a 0. This is the method bit relationship between 0. We have to calculate the 0 by as usually we have did. Now this is the method how we verify by using its coefficients. A, B are the coefficients of a given polynomial. So keep in mind this, if you have to calculate its zero by using coefficient method, you have to use minus b by a. What is b? B is a coefficient constant term, and what is a? Coefficient of x. Here the coefficient constant term is 3, so that's why I put here 3, and the coefficient of a, coefficient of x means 2. We put here, we get the values of g. So you have to verify in this manner for a linear polynomial. Please make a note. So now I am going to take an example or discussion with our quadratic polynomial. As you know, the quadratic polynomial can be represented as ax square plus bx plus c. Again, I revise, what's the coefficients? Here the constant term is c, the term which is not associated with x. It means if you find any terms that has not connected with x is called your constant term. In this there is no x, so that's why it is a constant term. And when I am talking coefficient of x, coefficient of x, then what is the coefficient of x? Means you have to look x, where it is x? Here x is. So the term associated with x is called coefficient. So what's the coefficient of x is here? B. Now what's the coefficient of x square? The term associated with x square is a. So the coefficient of x square is a. Now we have to same question. Now in first question, what we did, we take an example of a linear polynomial. Now I am taking an example of a quadratic polynomial. So this was your example. I am taking an example of x square minus 3x minus 4, because the highest power of x is 2, so it's a quadratic polynomial, and we have to find its zeros as usually we have did in our first questions by using the method of the splitting middle term. How we split it? The middle term is minus 3, and we, how we can write it as minus 4x plus me x. We take such question as already in our second lecture. So if I take x as common, I get x minus 4. If I take here 1 as a common, I will get x minus 4. and now taking x minus 4 as a common, we get here x, and from here we get x plus 1. And what's the 0? We have to put polynomial is equal to 0. So in this case, either x minus 4 is equal to 0 or x plus 1 equal to 0. If it is 0, then what's the value of x is equal to 4. If it is 0, then what's the value of x is equal to minus 1. So these are the two zeros, as we already did. Now the number of zeros of a quadratic polynomial is 2, and we get the values of zeros. Now we have to verify its coefficients method. Here we get two zeros, and what's the relation between zeros in terms of its coefficients? You have to know, and you have to learn and to write. Relation. Our first relation is, firstly we get two zeros. Here first zero is 4 and second zero is minus 1. And we denote first zeros by alpha. This is the symbol to represent our first zero. First zero is represented by a symbol alpha. And second zeros by represented by beta. In cubic polynomial, you also find another one zero, because a cubic polynomial has three zero. In that case, third zeros by symbol gamma. So alpha, beta, gamma are the basically to represent the zeros. So we are discussing quadratic. So in this we have two roots or two zeros. So first zero is represented by alpha and second zero is represented by beta. Now we have to find out the what's the relation between these two zeros. We have two relations. One is your sum of zeros, and second relation is product of zero. It's very important, and you have to keep in mind it every time whenever you do questions such type based on quadratic polynomials. First relation is sum of zeros. Sum of zeros means we have first zero is alpha and second zero is beta. It means we are calculating alpha plus beta, but is equal to, it's equal to, simply we write as minus b by a. What's the b? B is coefficient of x, so you have to write minus coefficient of x divided coefficient of x square. Again, if you want to calculate sum of zeros, then the formula is minus b by a. What is b? B is your coefficient of x. What is a? It's coefficient of x square. So I am writing here coefficient of x divided by coefficient of x square. We get an expression minus b by a. So alpha plus beta is equal to minus b by a. You can remember it. This one is your first relation. Now you have to learn its second relation, which is called product of zeros. What's the relation? Second relation is product of zeros. Product means we have to multiply the zeros. Our first zero is alpha and second zero is beta. Then we have to multiply alpha into beta. Alpha into beta. Alpha into beta is equal to simply c by a. What's the c? C is your constant term. It means alpha into beta is equal to your constant term divide me a. A is your coefficient of x square. So in this case, keep in mind, if you forget subscribe, by divide form, it means you have to look at denominator part. Denominator is the highest power of x, here highest power of x is 2. So in that case, every case in the denominator part is a. A is your highest power of x. So keep in mind, when I am talking about quadratic polynomial, we have two zeros, and the relationship between two zeros in terms of its coefficients is, first one is your sum of zeros. Sum of zeros, how we calculate? Because we have two zeros, and first zero is represented by alpha, and second zero is represented by beta, and sum of zeros means alpha plus beta, which is equal to minus p by a. And you know, what's the b? Coefficient of x. What's the a? Coefficient of x square. Similarly, you calculate the product of zero, because we have two relations. One is your sum of zero, second one is your product of zero. Product of zero is represented by alpha into beta, which is equal to c by a. C is your constant term and a is your coefficient of x square. So that's why I had constant term divided by coefficient of x square. So please make a note first, then we will verify this question. Now you have to verify. Now I am doing verifications. Verification. Firstly, sum of zeros. Sum of zero is equal to minus p by a. Or you can take alpha plus beta is equal to minus b by a. Now put this value. Alpha is your first zero, and what's the first zero is? X is equal to 4 plus second zero is beta, here which is equal to minus. Here minus. What is b? B is the coefficient of x. Here, what is the coefficient of x? Is minus 3. So we write minus 3 divided by a, coefficient of x square. What's the coefficient of x square? If it's, there is no value associated with x square, we have to consider it as 1. Have to put 1. 4 plus minus minus. 4 minus 1 is equal to 3. Now solve this. Minus minus plus 3 by 1, which is also equal to 3. So 3 is equal to 3. It means we verified. So please make a note first, then we verify by using product of 0 also. So now we have to verify by using product of 0 also, and we know product of zeros, which is alpha into beta is equal to c upon a. Our first zero is x is equal to 4, it means power, multiply second zero is beta and second zero is minus 1. Now put here c. What is c? C is the constant term. Look at this. What's the constant term is minus 4. And what is the coefficient of x square, which is equal to 1. 4 into minus 1, minus 4. Again, minus 4. Minus 4 is equal to minus 4. It means this statement is true. So, result verified. So, such type of question is solved in this manner. Now I am going to take another one example with for a question which is based on such type of concept. Please make a note first. So now I am going to take an example which type of question is will be put in your final exam. Look at the question. Find the zeros. It means we have to find the zeros, and we know how we calculate the number of zeros of a quadratic, as we already discussed what's a quadratic polynomial. Then verify its relationship between zeros and coefficient. We already discussed between, because we have known what's the relationship between two its zeros, either product of zeros or sum of zeros. We can easily find out. So do this question. Firstly, write your polynomial. Which one is your polynomial? Is p of x is equal to x square plus me 7x plus me 10. So we have to find the zero. So what we use? Method of middle term splitting. So we are using method of Middleton splitting, and we have to factorize, or you can say that find out the number of zeros. Firstly, 7 is factorized or 2 divided into equal parts. If we add them, we get 7, and if we multiply, we get it 10. It means naturally 5 plus 2. So 7x can be written as 5x plus me 2x plus me 10. Here we can take common as a x. We will take common x, but we will got here we got x plus 5. If we take common 2 from here, but we will got 2x plus 5. Now we can take common x plus 5. If I take a common x plus 5, then here I will got x and here x plus 2. Now we have to calculate its 0, so we have to put the polynomial is equal to 0 and get the values of x. What's the values of x is? If I put x plus 5 is equal to 0, then values of x is minus 5. If I put x plus 2 is equal to 0, then what's the values of x plus 2 is minus 1. Means we got two zeros. X is equal to minus 5 and second one is x is equal to minus 2. This is our method to find the zeros. Now what we have to do? We have to do verification source. Now we verify. So how do we verify? By using two relationships, sum of zeros and product of zeros. So first one is sum of zeros. What's the formula? Alpha plus beta is equal to minus b by a. And what's the relationship, or what's the general equation of a quadratic polynomial is? Our general form is p of x is equal to ax square plus me dx plus me c. And our polynomial is p of x is equal to x square plus me 7x plus me 10. If we compare them, then we can easily find out the values of a, b and c. Look at the coefficient of x square is a. Here is 2. It means the values of a is equal to 2. What's the coefficient of x is b. And here what's the coefficient of x is 7. So we get b is 7. Here the constant term, here is c, and here the constant term is 10. Then value of c is 10. We easily got the values of a, b and c by comparing its which are general equation of a quadratic polynomial. Now you have to put out alpha is your first zero, and first zero is minus 5 plus the second zero is minus 2. We put here, but we will got minus 5 minus 2, which is equal to minus 7. Now we have to verify on right hand side also. So put minus b. What's the value of b is 7. What's the value of a is 2. Here what's the value of a is 1, because the coefficient is 1. So coefficient of x square is a, and coefficient of x square is 1. So value of a is 1. So 7 divided by 1, but we will go minus 7. It means 2. Verified. Now second relationship is product of zeros. Product of zeros. Product of zeros means alpha into beta, which is equal to c by a. And what's the values of c is 10, and what's the values of a is 1. It means we get 10 on the right hand side. Now we have to calculate its left hand side. Alpha is our first roots, minus 5. Multiply. Beta is second zeros, x is equal to minus 2. Now multiply them, minus minus plus, 5 into 2, 10. Again true. So minus 5 and minus 2 are its zeros, because you are verified. So minus 5 and minus 2 are the zeros of the this quadratic polynomial. I hope you will understand this concept. Please make a note first. So now I am going another one example which is also based on a quadratic polynomial. The same question is we have to verify the zero and we have to verify by using the coefficient relationship between the zeros and the coefficients. So look at the polynomial is x square minus 3, but it is not a general form. So please look at this. What's the necessary and sufficient condition to be a quadratic polynomial? It is a quadratic polynomial, but you can see its three terms because quadratic polynomial has three terms. But it is not necessary that it always have three terms. It may be only one term also. But the necessary and sufficient its condition is what? We know our quadratic polynomial is the form of is ax square plus bx plus c, and a never be equal to 0. The necessary condition is a never be equal to 0, because if a becomes 0, then it becomes 0 x square. So we got a polynomial which is linear polynomial, because we get highest power of x is only 1. So in this case, the sufficient condition is highest power of the coefficient not be 0 at any cost. So in this case, highest power of x is 2. So this coefficient is not 0. So that's why it is a quadratic polynomial. So firstly, we have to write in terms of your quadratic polynomial and compare it with general equations. So here, p of x is firstly we have to write the x square and the terms, because here no term is associated with the x square, then what will be its value is 1. So the coefficient of x square is 1, but here is no terms of in terms of x, so you can take in terms of 0 plus 0 into x, because 0 into x it is equal to 0. So if we write this, then the quadratic polynomial will not be changed. That's why I have write here 0x, then the third term is minus 3. If we compare it, firstly we have to find out the coefficient of x square. What's the coefficient of x square is a, and here is x square is equal to 1. So we get x is a is equal to 1. Now compare it. The coefficient of x is b, but here the coefficient of x is 0. It means we get the value of b is equal to 0. Now here the constant term is c, and here constant term is 3, but it has negative sign. So we take sign also. Keep in mind, we cannot ignore its sign. We have to take the sign whenever we are talking about constant term or whatever the coefficient, we have to take its sign also. So we got the values of a, b and c. So we have to verify it. So firstly we have to calculate its number of zeros. So our polynomial is p of x is equal to x square minus 3. So this is the simplest form. Whenever you find any two terms in terms of square, must be keep in mind a square minus b square, because such identity is very important and it applicable in so many questions. So always whenever you do quadratic equation or whatever any solution, you keep in mind if you find any two terms that comes in square, you have used the identity a square minus b square. So make it in the form of a square minus b square. How we make it? Because 3 can be written as, because we already know if we have two terms, square root of 3 into square root of 3, and these are in terms of multiplication, and we know the multiplications of the square root, we get a single square root on which the numbers will be multiplied. 3 into 3 we got 9, and what's the square root of 9 is 3. It means we can write 3 as square root 3 into square root 3, and this can also be written as root 3 square, because if we write 2 into 2, so this can be written as 2 square of 2. Similarly, root 3 has 2 times, so we can write root 3 as a square form. So we apply such a concept here. This one is your x square and 3 can be written as square of root 3. Now what's the identity? A square minus B square is equal to A minus B and A plus B. So what's the value? X minus root 3, because here A is X and B is root 3. So A minus B and A plus B. So here we get X minus root 3 is equal to 0. Or x plus root 3 is equal to 0. If it is 0, we get x is equal to root 3. If it is 0, we get x is equal to minus root 3. It means we get 2 0. First 0 is x is equal to root 3, and second 0 is x is equal to minus root 3. Now we have to do its verification. So how we do verifications? First, sum of zeros. Alpha plus beta is equal to minus b by a. For them, alpha is your first zero, and first zero is root 3. Plus second zero is minus root 3. So root 3 plus minus minus root 3 minus root 3, which is equal to 0. Now you have to verify by this. Minus, what is b? B is 0. What is a? A is equal to 1. If we divide 0 by any number, we get 0. It means we get 0. True. So we verified. Now we have to verify its product of zeros. Product of zeros means alpha into beta, which is equal to c by a. Our first zeros is root 3, second zeros is minus root 3, and we know root 3 into root 3 is 9, and square root of 9 is 3. It means we get 3, and sign is negative. Now apply this. What is c? Is 3. And what is a? 1. So minus 3 by 1 is equal to minus 3. Also verify. I hope such concept will be clear to you. This concept is very important, and you have to clear all the concept. Don't forget to any concept, because this is the base to do simplifications type questions. So it's very important. We will continue it with our next video. So soon you will got another video. So don't forget to subscribe my channel if you like my video. So again, I appeal to, if you like my video, so please do subscribe Gaurav Gupta Math Classes. I hope you will like this video, and to share your friends also, so that everyone can find out or obtain benefits of my video. Thank you for watching my video. So we will take our next video. Thank you once again.